Welcome, dear students. Myself, Dr. Devesh Mishra. And in this session, I am going to discuss a very important topic of the biology, which is molecular biology, that is the polymerase chain reaction, PCR. Right? In short, we call them as a PCR, which stands for polymerase chain reaction. Right? So this topic is very important for exam, and you have to understand the concept behind the polymerase chain reaction, right? So polymerase chain reaction, first of all, we should know that who has discovered this. It was discovered by one scientist. His name was Carey Mullis. Carey Mullis has discovered this in 1985, and after 8 years, in 1993, won the Nobel Prize for this, right? So that can be a question also in exam, right? When it was invented, 1985, and when he got the Nobel Prize, that was 1993, right? So that is the important thing about the PCR. Now we have to understand what is the best definition of the PCR. That is very, very important. If you ask me what is the best definition of the PCR, so I will define that it is the DNA replication in vitro. See, usually or normally DNA replication you find in our human body, right? That is in vivo. But what we are seeing here, we are conducting one experiment in the lab, and that is why it is called as DNA replication in vitro. So this is called as DNA replication in vitro. So this is the best, or in short and crisp, if you want to define, you can say that DNA replication in vitro is called as polymerase chain reaction, right? So it is in the laboratory, that is why it is called as in vitro, right? In vitro, DNA replication in vitro is the simple and sweet definition of the polymerase chain reaction. Now we will see what are the requirements we have for the polymerase chain reaction, means what are the key ingredients, right? So what are the key ingredients we require in polymerase chain reaction, right? Polymerase chain reaction, basic thing is we have to amplify one desired DNA segment, right? We have to amplify one desired DNA segment. So that is the number one essential thing which we require. So number one is the DNA segment, or in simple word, we can say that DNA template, right? So we require a DNA template which has to be amplified, right? So this is the DNA template, right? So number one key ingredient for the polymerase chain reaction is the DNA template, right? Why this is the DNA template, which is desired DNA template, right? Desired template to be amplified. So this DNA segment we wanted to amplify it in our experiment of the polymerase chain reaction, right? So this is number one thing. What is the second important thing which you will be requiring? Second important thing which we will be requiring is the DNA nucleotides, because in this process we have to form the second DNA strands, right? So we have to prepare the complementary DNA strands. To prepare the complementary DNA strands, we require DNA nucleotides or DNA bases, which are, what are these things? These are the adenine, guanosine, thymine, adenine, guanine, thymine, and cytosine, right? So what are these things? Adenine, which I will be writing A, right? This is guanine, right? Which is in capital G. This is thymine, which is capital T, and this is cytosine, which is capital C, right? So now you can see these are the various DNA bases which are forming the DNA nucleotides, right? So these nucleotides or DNA bases we require as a one of the key ingredient in the PCR analysis, right? So first, what we have seen, DNA template we require. Second, we require DNA nucleotides. And third, we require the most important thing here is the primer, right? So the most important thing which we have to discuss here is the primers, right? So what are the primers? Now the question is, what are the primers? So primers are the short stretches of the DNA. If you ask me what are the primers, these are the short DNA stretches of the segment, right? So short DNA stretches are called as primers, right? So short DNA stretches are called as primers, and they are made up of 10 to 20 nucleotides. Remember, so they are made up of 10 to 20 nucleotides. So now you can see they are very small, right? So they are very small, 10 to 20 nucleotides, short segments of the DNA, they are called as primers. So what is the function of the primer? What is the function of the primer? Remember, it's a starting point for the PCR. That chain reaction will start from the primer, right? That is why they are important. So we can say in a simple words, they are the starting point. They are the starting point for DNA synthesis, right? So we require DNA synthesis, right? So for that DNA synthesis, starting point is the primer, right? So this primer is the starting point. Now I will show you what it does in DNA replication. Suppose I'm showing you these are the two DNA strands, right? These are the two DNA strands I'm just showing you, just for example, to explain this, right? And suppose these are the bases on this strand. So both the ends after the separation, see, these are the two DNA strands. What I'm showing you, these are the two DNA strands which has been separated, right? After separation of the DNA strands, we will be adding the primer to the ends, right? So now here we are going to add the primer. So this is the primer number one, right? Second end, the another end will be also having addition of the another primer. So this primer will now start formation of the complementary strand to this DNA, and this primer will be forming complementary strand to this DNA, right? So that is why I said it is a starting point for the DNA synthesis. So that is the importance of the primer. Short DNA stretches which will be added at the both ends of the DNA strand, and then they will form the new complementary strand. So what I want to say that after showing this diagram, why I have shown that, see how many primers are required in polymerase chain reaction, that is very important. So always remember there will be requirement of the two primers, right? So that is why you can see here I have written primers. So that is why there are two primers which are required for the DNA replication in the polymerase chain reaction. So this is the third important ingredient, right? Fourth important ingredient which you will see in polymerase chain reaction, which is very very essential, that is the TAC polymerase. This is called as TAC polymerase enzyme, right? So this is very important, TAC polymerase enzyme. Why, what is the TAC polymerase enzyme, right? Now try to understand basic thing about the TAC polymerase. It's a DNA polymerase only, right? It's a DNA polymerase. In human DNA replication, what you used to see that these are the DNA polymerase only. These are the DNA polymerase only, right? This DNA polymerase has been extracted from the bacterium, which is called as Thermus aquaticus. Thermus aquaticus, right? So Thermus aquaticus is a bacterium. It is a bacterium from which this DNA polymerase has been extracted, right? So that is why you can see the name itself is telling TAQ. So that is why the name is TAC. If you look at this name, TAC polymerase. So this TAC is derived from this only, right? So this one alphabet and these two alphabets have been taken together, and now they are called as Thermus aquaticus or TAC polymerase. So these are the DNA polymerases. What is the specialty of this DNA polymerase? This DNA polymerase is thermostable. Remember, this DNA polymerase is thermostable, means they can survive at, or they will be functional at temperature of 72 degrees Celsius also, right? So that is very important to understand. Why we are choosing TAC polymerase? Why we are not choosing? Now the question is, why we are not choosing the DNA polymerase in the human being? Why we are not choosing the DNA polymerase of the E. coli, right? Why we are not choosing these things? Why these are not chosen? Because they all will be active only at 37 degrees Celsius, right? So that is the very big limitation, remember. So now the question was, why we are not using, why the human and E. coli DNA polymerase is not used? Because their activity is only up to the 37 degrees Celsius. When the temperature goes above, they will be inactivated. And polymerase chain reaction, when I will explain the procedure, you will see that their temperatures are very high. that is 30 that is 96 degrees Celsius for denaturation, 50 degrees Celsius for annealing, and then again you are hitting at the doing the extension at the 72 degrees Celsius. So now you can see it's a higher temperature. So at those temperature, this human or E. coli polymerase will be inactivated. That is why we have taken out the new polymerase, which is called as TAC polymerase, from the bacterium, which is thermostable, which will be functional, or maximum activity will be present at 72 degrees Celsius. Means it is suitable to handle extreme temperatures of the polymerase chain reaction. That is why TAC polymerase has been chosen, right? What is the another important point about this TAC polymerase? If we don't have this TAC polymerase, then probably that primer will not be extended. Try to understand. Again, I explain what happens with this TAC polymerase. This TAC polymerase will add, remember what they are going to do? They are going to add the DNA nucleotides. Right? So remember this, what is the function of the TAC polymerase? They will add DNA nucleotides to whom? To the primers. And when they will add this DNA nucleotides to the primers, so that is very important to understand. This concept is very, very important to understand. What is the function of TAC polymerase? To add the DNA nucleotides to the primers, and then only you will see the complementary strands will be synthesized. So complementary DNA strands will be synthesized, because see, primer was very small, 10 to 20 nucleotides, right? So how this will expand and they will form the complementary strand? They require more nucleotide, right? They'll be requiring more nucleotide. So who will be adding more nucleotide? Who is going to add more nucleotide? This TAC polymerase is going to add more nucleotide, right? That is why we have chosen DNA nucleotides, adenine, right? Thymine, guanine, right? So all these things we are adding so that the primer should be having extension. So that is the last step which we will be discussing further, right? So this is how there will be complementary DNA strand will be synthesized, and that process of chain elongation will be completed, right? So these are the four important things which you will be requiring, four important things which we will be requiring for the any kind of PCR, right? So what is the number one thing? Number one thing is desired template, right? Second thing is all the DNA nucleotide ATGC. Third important thing is the primer, right? Which are the short stretches of the DNA, and both the ends of the DNA will be requiring, right? Both the strands, their ends will be requiring. That is why there are two primers we are going to use. And remember, without primer, there can be nothing, right? That is why I have written here, starting point for the DNA synthesis is the primer, right? And then we require the TAC polymerase enzyme, which is very important, because this is the thermostable enzyme which will add the DNA nucleotides along with the primer, and this is how chain elongation will happen. So these are the four ingredients and their importance in the polymerase chain reaction. Now come and see what is the principle of the polymerase chain reaction. So basic principle of the polymerase chain reaction, see, I am showing you, this is the two DNA strands, right? And suppose these are the base pairs which are complementary to each other, and they are all in the one strand. That is why, because of the hydrogen band, right? Because of the hydrogen bond, right, between the base pairs. So what is the basic principle in polymerase chain reaction? We will heat this double stranded DNA strands. So see, I am writing DNA strands, and this is the double stranded. So I'm just writing in the bracket 2. So it is double stranded DNA. So what we are going to do, we are going to heat it. Heat at 96 degrees Celsius. And as a result, what will happen? Now these DNA strands will be separated. Now you can see DNA strands has been separated, right? So now they have been separated, right? So now we can see, after heating at 96 degrees Celsius, two strands are separated, right? So two strands are separated. So now two separate strands are formed. So after this two separate strands formation, what we are going to do, we are going to take the help from the three things, right? Try to understand what I'm saying. We are going to take the help from three things. Number one is the tag polymerase. You remember that enzyme which will be adding DNA nucleotides, right? So this will be adding DNA nucleotides, and to whom they are going to add? To the primers, right? So with the help of all these three things, right? With the help of all these three things, see what is the basic principle. First, we are separating the two DNA strands, then by heating 96 degrees Celsius, then we are finding the separate strands of the DNA with the help of three important things. One, enzyme tag polymerase. Second, DNA nucleotides and primers. We will be synthesizing complementary strands, right? So this is how we will be synthesizing complementary strands. So complementary strands are synthesized, right? So by this process, what we will see that complementary strands will be synthesized like this. This is the complementary strand for this one. And say this is the complementary strands for this one, right? So now you can see that what we are seeing, one DNA molecule is forming two DNA molecules, right? And this process will be keep going on. Two will form four and so on. So that is how we are seeing the segment of DNA has been multiplied, or you can say amplified, right? So that is why the name is polymerase chain reaction. So it's kind of chain reaction. One will form two will form four, and this will be keep going on, right? For the multiple cycles. So that is the basic principle of the PCR, right? So as I was telling you, this is the basic principle. You heat the DNA strand, convert them into single stranded, right? After single stranded conversion, you will take the help of tag polymerase enzyme, which will add DNA nucleotides to the primers. And now the primer will expand and they will form the complementary strand for the original strand. That is how the DNA molecules will be formed again, right? So that is how we are going to prepare. So this is the basic principle. Now I am going to tell you about the steps of the polymerase chain reaction. So what are the three steps of PCR, right? So now I'm going to explain the three steps of the polymerase chain reaction. So what are these three steps? I will first tell you. Number one is denaturation, second is annealing, and third is elongation. So these are the important three steps, right? So what are these three steps? Number one is denaturation, right? After denaturation, there will be annealing. And third step, the final step, is called extension or elongation, right? So third step is extension or elongation, right? So these are the three important steps of the polymerase chain reaction, which I'm going to explain one by one. So number one is the denaturation. So what happens in denaturation? As you can see, the name itself is telling that hydrogen bond will be broken down between the two bases of the DNA molecule by heating. Right. So what we do actually here, now I again explain you. Suppose these are the two DNA strands, right? And suppose these are the base pairs. These are the base pairs which are attached with the hydrogen bond, right? So as I said, these are attached with the hydrogen bond. These are all attached with the hydrogen bond, right? So what we do in denaturation, we do the heating, right? So we are heating the DNA strands, right? So double stranded DNA is heated, right? Heated at what temperature? 96 degrees Celsius. Because of this, what will happen? Now both the strands will be separated. So as a result, now we will see that this hydrogen bond will be broken down, right? So in short, I will write hydrogen bond breakdown. Right. So because of the hydrogen bond breakdown between the bases, now you will see the separate strands of the DNA. Now you will see there is a one strand which is the separate, and there is the second strand which is the separate. So hydrogen bond is gone. Right. So now we are seeing the two separate DNA strands. Right. So two separate DNA strands are achieved. Right. So now we have achieved two separate DNA strands. This is the process of denaturation. Simple process. You heat them, you heat the double stranded DNA, they will break down into the two pieces, means the hydrogen bond will be broken down, and now the two strands are complementary strands are now detached or they are separated, right? So this is the denaturation, right? After denaturation, the second step is annealing. What happens in annealing, right? So first we have to understand what is annealing in metallurgies. Some element metallurgy like copper, first we will heat them at the higher temperature, then we will be bringing them to the lower temperature for stabilization of the alloy. Same thing we are doing here. Can you see this? First we have heated the sample at 96 degrees Celsius, right? But that 96 degrees Celsius, primer will not attach to this DNA strand. Remember, primer will not attach to the DNA strand. So remember, for attachment of the primer to the separated strands, we have to bring down the temperature, right? So that is called annealing. So in annealing, what we are doing, we are cooling it to the temperature of 50 degrees Celsius, right? So to the temperature of 50 degrees Celsius. Remember, we are bringing it to the 50 degrees Celsius. Why? Because at this temperature only, primers will attach to the DNA strands, right? So that is the very important point to understand. Why? What is the necessity of annealing? Why we require this? So that primer can attach to the DNA strand. Now you can see what is happening. These two DNA strands which has been separated, and I was telling you these are the base pairs, right? So primers will be having complementary base pair to them. Suppose I'm showing you this is the primer. Suppose I'm showing you this is the primer for this strand, and this is the primer for this strand, right? So in short, I'm writing P for primer, right? And this red segment, these are the separated DNA strands. So this red color is the separated DNA strands, right? So this attachment of the primer to the bases will require the cooling temperature, which is the 50 degrees Celsius. It will not happen at 96 degrees Celsius, right? So this process is called annealing. So can you see this? How it is correlating to the metallurgy of those elements? We are bringing the temperature down so that primer can attach to the DNA complementary sequences, right? After this, the third and the most important step is the extension, right? So third and the most important step will be extension. See this. What I have shown you in the primer attachment during annealing, right? Primer is very short segment, right? So it is not going to form the complete strand, right? It is not going to form the complete strands complementary to the original DNA strand. So what they require? They require more DNA nucleotides, right? They require more addition of the DNA nucleotide. So how it will happen? It will happen during extension, right? How it will happen? It will happen during extension. Again, I will draw this just to make you understand more comfortably that these are the DNA original or parental strands which I have drawn. And then I have shown you the primer. This is the primer which will be having complementary strands, right? These are the primers which will be having complementary sequences to the parental strand, right? So now what is required for this to extend? So for this extension, what they require, I'm just making this one. For this extension, as I said, they require DNA nucleotides, right? So they require A, T, G, C, right? All these DNA nucleotides they require, right? So these DNA nucleotides, who will provide this? So this will be provided by TAC polymerase, or this can be helped by TAC polymerase. So now TAC polymerase will add all these. So right now you can see that what is happening? TAC polymerase is adding all these DNA nucleotides to the primers, right? So all these adding DNA nucleotides. What are these things? These are the DNA nucleotides, right? So these are the nucleotides to be added. They are adding DNA nucleotides to primers, right? So now you understood what is the function of the DNA TAC polymerase. They are going to add these DNA nucleotides to the primer. At what temperature? Now the question is at what temperature it will be functional, not at 50 degrees Celsius. This TAG polymerase will be active. Remember, this TAG polymerase will be active at 72 degrees Celsius, right? So now you can see that extension will happen 72 degrees Celsius, where TAG polymerase is the thermostable enzyme which will add DNA nucleotides to the primers. And then it will be forming the complete strand. So now, because of this, you will be seeing there are two strands of the DNA. Now you can see there is a parental DNA. I am showing you, this is the parental DNA strand. And because of the primer, now you will see there is a complementary strands. Now you can see there is a complementary strand has been formed. So you can now see there are two DNA molecules, right? So now you can see that there are two DNA molecules. There is a one DNA molecule, this one, and there is another DNA molecule, this one. So that is why it is called as chain reaction. So it is a kind of chain reaction. Now they will form another two. This will form another two. So that is why it's a kind of chain reaction. Do you understand? This will form another two. This will form another two. So that is why name is polymerase chain reaction, right? So now you understood polymerase chain reaction. These are the three important steps. I again repeat what happens in denaturation. That is very important to understand and remember this important thing, that denaturation will be heating at the 96 degrees Celsius. DNA strands are separated. After that, what comes? Annealing. Annealing at what temperature? It is 50 degrees Celsius, where primer will be getting attached to the DNA strands, right? Which is very important for the starting the synthesis, as you can see in this discussion. After that, we will require extension at 72 degrees Celsius with the help of TAG polymerase enzyme, right? So this is how you can see DNA strands has been formed. So these are the basics of the polymerase chain reaction. So dear students, if you like this video lecture, you share it with your friends. And post in your comment box, if you want me to prepare some more lectures, post in the comment box. I will come up with a new lecture. Till then, bye bye, see you, and best wishes.